I'm going to delete another shot. Got a disease. See, look, there's no need for me to be here. Deleting this shot. Oh, it's working! All right. Here we go. See? I remember my shots.
See, it's all the same.
That's fine. Look, this is my own ecosystem. I'm deleting. I decided, Bryce, that we didn't need 7 different positions of overlays.
So we're just... You saved your own, though. You saved your own.
Yeah, man. Yours is good. You got your own house. All right, Justin. Yo, buddy.
Hey, man. So we're streaming to Muffin, we're streaming to Twitch, right?
Yep, I believe we're streaming to all the things that, we are promised and beholden to stream upon.
All right. I do want to, we'll make sure that we're doing that so everybody's cool, but we're doing the live show.
Look at this. I'm destroying this shot. So long, shot. This one is fine. At some point, I might go get in that chair.
You're not going to be able to because you're going to want to do shit.
I know. I'm here. Well, that's why I have... hold on, let me show you. I thought this through.
Ethereal Vision says, I'm 12, and what is this? That's what 12-year-olds always do, is just announce their age before they say anything. I'm 32. What are taxes?
you go to a bar, you're like, I'm 70. Fuck you. I got nothing.
I'm 70. What's gonorrhea?
All right, here we go. Here we go. Feeling it. I guess I'll leave that one on. Probably gonna kill this one. I say we just go with this one. We just show this nonsense.
Just the empty chair. With both of our graphics on it. Like, the empty negative space is representative of both Brian and Justin.
It seems legit. So I guess a lot of the stuff that we have on there, you know, reminded people, no, we don't need two Justins watching Scam School Remix. Gone. This one, again, I'm convinced someday I'll get in that chair, but I know I won't.
I don't think you're going to do it because you're going to want to be flipping and flopping.
Yeah, but like Bonnie might sit there or something. What about this this zoomed in
this
on your
chin? This is a good shot. All right, so what do you think that this shot should be for? Like, should it just be like a like narrator guy?
It should be next time you want to violate the terms of service and impersonate Ted Twitch.
Ted Twitch. Well, here, hold on. Wait, maybe if I took the if I took the lighting down a little bit. Like, it would be, like, very artistic. It's like, it was that day. Like, this is, like establishing shot.
But like, the weird part is that it cuts off your eyes. And so instead, we're just watching your nose. No, I'm sorry. I'm killing it.
No, wait. Hold on. Wait. Let me try this.
All right.
So now this is, like, establishing shot of a movie about radio. So you just see the, like... Now coming back, all ships at sea. There is a deal on pomade at Old Granddad's Fun Shack.
Old Granddad's Fun Shack. What do they have at Old Granddad's Fun Shack?
Old Granddad's Fun Shack. The one and only place for pinstripes, bow ties, bull weevils, tic tacs, and more meegs. Everybody come on down. Old Granddad's Fun Shack. You know where to go for it. Bye.
All right, I'm deleting this. Again, I keep thinking maybe I'll sit over there someday, but I don't think I will.
Merman 1983, this is not a rebroadcasting. Or sorry, this is. This is a rebroadcast from yesterday.
It's the weirdest thing. We actually recorded the show last week. We didn't know who would be there, so we just got in the habit of shouting out random names.
Hopefully they'll match up with this one. Before we knew that Twitch was a thing, so this is definitely not streaming on Twitch. We didn't know that Twitch was a thing.
Hey, look at that. I will accept this one. Ha-ha! See, I could take a bunch of these. I could salvage all this. I could make it work. This one, again, not getting it. Deleting. God, I'm just saving so much.
I like this is a great bit.
How about this one?
Price's shots.
How about this one? Black screen, empty chair, and sliver of Justin in the corner. Can you lean in and just give us like you're peeking in from the other dimension with General Zod?
Yeah. Oh. Here. Yeah. Where am I?
Yeah. All right. All right, I think that'll work. Everything goes much faster now. Saving. Oh, I saved over the main
okay,
file.
I guess we're having a problem with Muffin CDN. People are saying that it's only a only a loading diamond.
Mm-hmm.
Let me try to see here.
Black screen is in studio. Can be. Oh, yeah. Well, that means I might actually use that. Okay, good point. I'll leave those. I'll leave those black screens. That'll be good. Oh, I see now. That's the one when there's someone in studio, and that's when it's me and you.
Oh, I see it.
Yeah.
There yeah, look at that.
All right. We're good,
hey,
man.
Hey, man. So,
so we're just going to do this, right? We're just going to sit back? Here, let me bring back some more of that music. Here we go. This is the stream.
This is pretty much what do we do before when we did BB Live Show? Like what happened?
Oh, it was this. I would just play music in the background. We horse shit around, and I would like literally, we're shockingly close to exactly the old game plan.
I think we're more efficient, actually. I think, like, even in just farting around and futzing on the computer and deleting or creating shots, we're more efficient at it than we used to be.
Oh, absolutely. Here, watch this. You want to see a magic trick? Because right now I'm looking at this, but I can wait for... No, I guess this is the one I wanted. Never mind. Whoops. There we go. I'm off this one. Ready? Ah!
You should do that when you have a good point. So wait, flip it back and then like make an escalating point that like punctuates with you flipping the thing.
Hold on, this is a really good idea. All right, so unfortunately, I just broke this shot.
No, it's fine because you just be angry.
Well, here, I'll delete this shot, and then I'll...
This is Bri and Whiskers in the afternoon.
All right, here we go.
This is a new show that we're doing.
See, I'm going to duplicate this shot. I'm gonna set it up right next to it, right here, side by side. So this is the regular one, but then this one will be me shocked. There we go. Nope. There we go. So now we're sitting here, we're talking, and I'm like, well, I don't think so.
Oh, shit.
And then I'm like, all right, I guess you have me again. No way, sir.
No, you should do like opposite the tracks, or like maybe it's cold outside. Just like just flipping from one to the other.
Or maybe we'll do, now all of a sudden I'm into this. All right, so I could do this, and then I'm going to do another copy as well. We're going to have 18 million shots. It should be like this. Watch. All right.
Yeah. So, that's the goal. The goal when you're playing the game of Wirecast is to have as many shots as possible.
That's how you know that you got your money's worth.
Yeah. Otherwise, you're just farting around. Welcome, Renegoo. Balloon knots.
Oh, no. I fucked it up. Let me... here we go. Left. Aha! Okay, no. I'm getting it. I remember this language. And then... So, here we go. So, we're like this. And I'm like... Hold on, you.
Oh. Yeah.
Yep. And then I was going to have you flip, like, Hold on. Let me see if I can do something really dumb. Okay. All right. Hold on. There it is. All right. Here you go. So we're talking.
Yeah.
And I'm like, what's that, sir? And then you go, woo, hoo, hoo.
It's all a matter of perspective, Brian.
Oh, wow. I don't understand it at all. Oh, you're crazy, sir. Everything's all upside down and boogity-doo. Hey, do you want to go through the rest of the? I'm just gonna leave it like this. Do you want to go through the rest of the show doc videos from yesterday?
Sure. Yeah, man. Well, I mean, do we want to explain what we're doing, or just go?
Yeah, we're bringing back BB Live Show, and you're looking at it. It's two assholes farting around. You'll notice it even says Brian is testing a camera. Don't expect much.
No, I mean. Is there a reason why you left that? I never really got the backstory on that aside from just like assuming that it was like a thing that just gets set once and it's that forever.
I didn't know that was the case, but that's exactly what happens is like you know what? Maybe I will reverse myself so we could talk. No. It was the kind of thing where it's like, yep, sorry, you titled that your chat room and so it shall be forever. Congratulations, asshole.
Dude, I don't. Where did we get this idea? I mean, we were talking last night. We're like, man, what if we just went live? Like, I guess, like it just kind of felt like the right thing to do. Is just like let's have fucking fun.
You know what it is? It's that you know, I'm learning the value of Snapchat. I'm learning the value of putting out garbage. Like, not that it's intentionally bad, but like stuff with no stakes. Because think about it. How long has it been since we've had any streams where there were no stakes, no rules, and no benefits? I guess, you know, there's a tangible benefit in that we get to hang out with our friends here. But
yeah.
But I mean, as far as.
No, I mean, because it went kind of like this. We live streamed because we liked it. And then there was the possibility for it to be something else. So we were like kind of like, you know, paying our dues and sowing our oats and making our beans and turning our butter.
Yep.
You know, and then all of a sudden it's like you start getting paid for it. So it's like, okay. And then Patreon comes along and it's like, all right, so now everything that we do can be a thing that we're like making our career on, and it like keeps you off the road. It keeps me out of a 9-to-5 job. So it's like now that's like a huge thing that you want to make sure that you are maximizing your ability you know, to do that. And then, you know, now, I don't know, part of it is just the, you know, part of it is the ability of kind of opening up to a bunch of more people on Twitch and everything. But also, like, I think for both of us, it was just like, oh, wait, like, now we have time. Like, now you are off the road. Yeah, now I don't have a job.
Yeah, we've broken our glasses after the nuclear holocaust. We're like, there was finally time. And then we didn't use it, but now we're using it.
But now we're using it. Because, hey, like, you know, why not? Why not?
All right, I got a topic.
Go. All right. Topic the first. Stephen Cogswell, the genius, joining us here in the chat room.
Oh, by the way, I'm going to leave open Night Attack Show if you guys want to call in on Skype at any time. What's it going to take to get you?
Oh, that was another thing that we always had. We always just had random call-ins.
Yeah, yeah. The only thing
that's missing is a Cam Twist. Can somebody get us a Cam Twist trial logo that we can just embed
over?
Oh,
no, it was a VidBlaster.
VidBlaster trial.
Yeah. Yeah, I'll throw that on there. What's it going to take to get you to play Overwatch? Have you physically tried playing the game at all?
Oh, I went through, if she's not napping, she might come in here to join this conversation to yell at me. But Ashley, like, gave me, like, a tutorial. It was, like, a Saturday night, and she's like, guess what? You are going to sit down and play Overwatch. You're going to play the demo, and then we're going to do games together. I'm going to tell you who to pick. Like, you can follow my lead, like, you can do whatever you want, but, like, we're gonna do this thing. And so I did. And it's nice. It's cool. I like the game. I'm just, like, I have a a fear of my inadequacies in first-person shooters that prevents me from fully enjoying the game. I think that's the biggest thing.
So, like, even if you do well, you're like, well, I didn't do well enough. They're all laughing at me.
Well, number one, I mean, it would be nice to get to the point where I do well and then have to wonder how many, how I feel about doing well. But also, it's just doing anywhere other than awful takes is like a stressful journey. And it is not one that I find myself saying like, oh, when again can I go on this stressful journey to mediocrity? Like that was so fulfilling for me.
Yeah, but well, Captain Fubar, I think, has a good point. If you play Soldier 69, I think it's 76. Soldier 69.
Not the way he does it.
That's Santa's new movie that he shot with your mom last night, according to him. Boy, salty Santa, man. It was pretty good last night.
Dude, he was so good.
Oh, he's always so good.
He's just the best. Although I do, just even as a prop, the idea of wine just spilling all over his beard is always just one of my favorite things in the world. It's just like, it's like lush, like, you know, garbage Santa with his crazy beard is just so good.
So that's a no-go. Like, you just don't think you're going to get into...
No, I mean, probably not. I also have like a lot of things that just also require a lot of watching things now. Like there's not a ton of time that I find myself saying like, oh, well, here's some time that I can spend like delving into this other habit. Like, you know, between, especially now that I'm doing the wrestling show, do you know how much fucking wrestling programming is on weekly?
Dude, I would imagine more than two.
Brian, sweet, sweet summer child, Brian.
No, I'm sure there's a lot.
If you want to watch every show that the WWE itself, just the WWE, puts out, you are looking at 3 hours for their flagship show on Monday, mm-hmm. 2 hours for their secondary show on Tuesday, 1 hour for their minor league promotion on Wednesday, and then another hour of cruiserweight action that happens after their secondary show. That is a solid 7 hours of content. And that's if you only watch the WWE stuff. That's not if you want to watch anything else. That's not if you want to watch any documentaries or old stuff or whatever. Like, it is just a hefty thing.
How much of your time do you find going back through those the old catalogs? Because, I mean, I bet I would get a lot out of that, you know, in terms of nostalgia and so on. But for somebody who's all caught up to date, does it hold up to go back and re-experience?
Oh, yeah. Oh, totally. No, there's definitely, like, you know, especially well into the night, you know, you've had a few. Right, you just want to kind of
you want a consequence. Boy, I tell you what, that's the other thing, man. That's I don't want to say I lament it. I'm not going to say that it's not a delight and a privilege and an honor to be able to watch content and then get to run your dumb mouth off about how you feel about it. And somehow people, whether, you know, maybe they write you an email talking about how wrong you are, but they appreciate you enough that, you know, they support your patronage and all that. But there's definitely that moan of like, fuck, I gotta watch two more episodes of Ash vs. Evil Dead. You know, not for any other reason than because you've got a job to do. That show ain't gonna watch itself, man.
Yeah, no, you guys with Cord Killers, like, you know, Hotline Monday at least has the out that we can just do the like worst sequel show if either of us see the hot movie that came out over the weekend, right? Like, for you guys with Cord Killers, man, like, you guys always got to see fucking everything that comes out. At least one of you, probably both of you, have to see it. You got to watch every, like, if you're following the show, you're watching every episode, whether or not it's good or bad. Like you guys have cut out, I think, a very, very tough road to hoe in terms of, like, you know, that kind of criticism.
Yeah, but I mean, the good news is that the defining characteristic of what we cover in spoiler in time is that it's got to be stuff that we care about. And as a result, there'll be times that, like, I think we ran into it once, because usually there's an ongoing show that we're both excited about. But yeah, there was just a gap, and we're like, the 3%? Sure, let's watch the 3%. And then, you know, that was sort of picking it out of nowhere.
Did you watch the 3%? What is it about? Is it about milk?
It's about math. It's about, it starts off, it goes, if there's 100 donuts, how much is 3%? And then the guy, the scientist, says that. And then this kid from the streets is like, 3 donuts, yo. Only says it in Portuguese. And he's like, that is correct. But what is 3% of the human soul? And then it smash cuts to the title sequence opening, which is kind of a weird roller coaster ride through the circulatory system with like four puzzles going all around.
Is it like
and you see this count up of 0.1%, 2%, 3%.
And then it's like, oh, blood vessel, phlegm.
Right, and it like stops at like 0.08, and it, you know, and it says the legal limit to drive in the United States. And then
there's like, infotainment is hot right now, dude. Infotainment is so in. It just gives you little numbers.
It reminds me a lot of the old opening to Buck Rogers, where it's like he's trapped in time, and it's like time's going forward. But it's like this,
People keep reminding him what the legal limit to drive is based by states
exactly.
and everything.
Well, like, and then it says, you know, 1%, the richest 1% are this much of the populace. and then eventually
J.C. Calhoun nails it. So it's just a ripoff of Seinfeld.
Yes. All right. Yes, it is.
So that's the 3%. That's good. It's good to know. Because that's the end of the show. It's just the intro, right? Like, there's no – like, it's just
– Yes.
It's that establishment of the donut thing with the wise kid from the streets knowing the answer. And then it's the intro, and then it just goes right to credits.
That's exactly what happens. Hey, this is a good question. Jerry Fax is asking, like, we don't mess around on Twitch too much. Man, look, this is us learning to drive again. We forgot how to drive. We used to drive a stick shift, and then we went out and bought a Jeep, and now we're trying to learn how to drive a stick shift again.
By the way, is also what you're literally doing right now.
Oh, is it? What a coincidence.
Because you bought a Jeep. Jeep.
Dude,
the best days of my life. I was going to buy a Jeep.
$1.69.
He moved down to San Antonio. His wife didn't know where he was. She called him up on the phone.
There we go. This is me.
Oh.
I took the windows off again today.
Ryan's like, yeah, it's raging, just like white knuckling, right? Picking up milk at the HEB, just like doing bleach burnouts in the parking lot.
I did, I finished the initial construction on the kids' playscape. Oh, I wish I had taken a photo of the finished thing. But now it's like I'm trying to get it all balanced because, you know, you can appreciate where I'm coming from on this. Bonnie's like, hey, our playscape in the backyard, our playground is literally falling down. She walks over and she grabs a piece of board and rips it off. And she goes, I'm not freakishly strong. this is how decayed it is. We have to get into it. I'm like, okay, all right. And then it's like, you know, here's one that's comparable. It's like $800 or whatever. It's like, okay. And he's like, and you know, like I did this first one, took 2 days with your dad and it was fucking miserable. I'll never do it again. And I'm like, oh, okay. Like, so we're going to hire people to do it. I'm like, okay, all right. And then, and they're like, how much is that? We're like, I don't know, probably, $1,000 or whatever. And then she gets off the phone and she goes, yeah, I don't feel safe with setting up a playscape on this sloping hill because it's just going to fall over and kill everyone. So I called about how much it would be to level all that. And it's going to be, $3,000. And I'm just like, wait, whoa, 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 whoa. So to get another playground, which we already have, we have to buy the playground, we have to pay for the people to install the playground, and then we have to level the $5,000? And I was like,
yeah.
No. And I was like, we're going to buy the playground. I was like, I'll take care of it. She goes, well, no, it's a two-person job. You have to be professional, and you have to know what you're doing. And I'm like,
do you?
And I'm like, eh. And she goes, I swear to God, Brad, if that just sits in the backyard, I'm like, I'm going to do it. Didn't realize what a commitment it was. Didn't quite realize. I mean, it's
so
easy
you
to
might
say.
Have bit off a little more than you could chew is what you're saying.
I certainly thought that when I got everything. It's like, imagine just a lumberyard just shows up and that's that. And you get a pamphlet and it just says, hey, here's an idea. Just build it. And there are 97 one-page steps to assemble hundreds of different boards and hundreds of screws and bolts, and you got to have the GH5MX2 and not the 217 blurted guardy bars. But
hold on, let me see if I got a photo of it, of the initial thing almost done.
Yeah, take a look at that shit, son.
Oh, damn.
Yeah, let me.
So how long have you been building this?
A month and a half. It's been a while.
All right. So apparently, for whatever reason,
yeah,
watch is getting eaten in the chat.
What is watch?
The word watch.
You can't watch? Say the word watch?
I'm sure that it's just part of the mod, like it's like the banned words or something
the
like that.
Auto-mod. It's like we don't talk about what you're watching out in
public.
Nobody
watch what you're watching.
Watch this. Watch. No, it seems to. Oh, that's weird.
So it's only in the Twitch alerts embed because I'm seeing it in.
Yeah, no, it shows. Yeah, it shows on the Twitch chat, but on this one, it's amazing.
I wonder, is that in Twitch alerts that it does that?
I don't know. This is that Streamlabs thing that. Oh, hang on, we got TVZ gone on the line.
Yeah.
Yo, TVZ gone. What's up?
What's up, guys? How's it going?
Good. What's going on, boss?
I am just killing time, man. I've got like an hour to go at work, and I am I'm really done with today.
What happened, man?
Actually, it's an indictment of our dental institutions that I cracked a tooth eating potato chips at lunch today, and so I got to work from home tomorrow and go to the dentist and get a crown replaced.
Dude, is that not the greatest betrayal of getting old? Is like when your teeth get falling out, it's not even for something dope like you pissed off a bouncer. It's because you ate a potato chip.
Exactly. I should have probably just stuck with like oatmeal and I don't even know, like, you know, soft foods or something. I'm gonna fall apart, and I just need to go out to pasture and not even move.
All right. Well, so you're working, and I assume you're misappropriating company time and resources to call us. What can we do to make your day?
Well, I heard you talking about your Jeep earlier, and I saw the posts about it and stuff like that, and I want to make sure that you're not damaging that poor vehicle due to let's just say riding the clutch or misshifting, grinding the gears and things like that, because it is a fine piece of engineering.
Yeah, Brian, how does he know for a fact that you're not ruining such a beautiful car by your mishandling of the thing?
You don't get to know it all. As a matter of fact, I'm pretty sure I am. I don't even know what it means to ride a clutch. What does that mean? When you keep the clutch too much?
Yeah. What you can do is you keep your foot on the clutch and you keep pushing in a little bit, and it just kind of your gears are still engaged, but you're just pushing just enough to, remember the clutch is a friction plate pushing the transmission you know, basically to so you can push the gears away from each other so you can shift gears. So right. if you're riding the clutch, you're basically eating up. It's like riding your brakes.
Got
except
it.
It's your clutch. And it's a hell of a lot more expensive to tear a clutch apart than it is to replace brake pads.
Got it. So so only use. All right. Now, King of Random, you know, my new friend on YouTube, Grant was saying that you could actually, if you time it right and do it just so, you could switch gears without even using the clutch. Is that a thing?
That is a thing too. It's definitely some more advanced type stuff, but yeah, if you time it correctly, you can basically, the way I've done it with my cars, cause I mostly driven manual transmissions only, same thing with my wife, which is an incredibly nice thing to say about her is that what she wanted after having a Toyota that didn't have an automatic or that had an automatic was my next car is going to have a stick shift. And that was pretty darn amazing. But if you're driving and you know you're going to need to shift, what you do is you kind of you put the pedal down a little bit, you lift the throttle just a bit, your revs drop down a bit, and then you can shift down. What you want to do is you're manually matching the revs from like first gear to second gear to third gear, because you know when you shift, your revs will drop down about 1,000 RPM or so.
Right.
So you're basically timing that. And if you do it correctly, yeah, it's literally just like you hear it just click and it's perfect. And if you tuck it up, you hear it and then yeah. you go, oh shit.
Okay. Now twice I've felt that moment. Like, does that mean my car is instantly broken that I felt that once?
Luckily, no. One nice thing with modern manual transmissions is they are what they call synchro mesh gears. So there's extra, I guess almost you could call them flanges on the gears to help them come together more easily. So there's basically, you know, you might be removing a little bit of material, but it's not anything that can be too bad. I will say one of my proudest achievements was when the clutch, we had a Kelsey, my wife's car into the dealership and they're doing a bunch of work. And they're like, well, while we're in there, we can replace the clutch if you pay for parts. And we're like, yeah, sure, go for it. Cause that's like, you know, $1,000 by itself. And the guys, when they were taking it apart, they said, okay, we're going to replace, you know, the friction plate and they're going to replace, you know, all the bearings and stuff. But they're like, yeah, we don't need to take care of your pressure plate because you guys have been driving this car nicely and it shows nowhere at all. And that was at like 70,000 miles. And I was like, hell, apparently I'm doing something right for once.
Well, all right. But if you're not an expert at riding with a standard vehicle, does it make it better on the engine ultimately if you're playing Ba with Da Ba by Kid Rock at least once a day?
Well, I'm pretty sure there's some state regulations in Texas that require that to a certain extent. I mean, correct me if I'm wrong, but I believe that part of the country has those rules on the books right now.
Sorry, can't hear you, man. I got the windows off. I'm doing 45 miles an hour. Just down the street from the neighborhood.
Exactly.
But I'm now just convinced that Ba with Da Ba is the white people's La Cucaracha. Like, it's just immediately likely. You know exactly where you are when you're in a Jeep and Ba with Da Ba is playing.
Yeah, now we need to get some Instagram video of you doing that, Brian. With all the girls in the car,
oh,
everybody
yes.
wearing dark sunglasses.
Well, okay, all right. Well, we're all set up for that. I took off all the clothes. The Jeep's naked right now. But I started doing Instagram stories. I know you do Snapchat, right? So you already have fans on Snapchat or whatever. Mm-hmm. But I started doing Instagram stories, which I guess is just like Snapchat. It's like do Instagram
they,
photos.
They,
that
yeah,
are garbage.
They basically took. They took the Snapchat idea of oversharing, right? Like, yeah. So Instagram had this reputation that apparently the young people.
Here, like, hold on 1 second. I'm gonna do it. All right, yeah. I'm learning about more about Instagram stories. Go on. You were saying.
So the idea with Instagram was always that you're getting the perfect thing, right? You're taking the perfect picture. You look amazing. Yada yada yada, and even. Like, kids apparently would use it differently than olds like me and you and, like, delete pictures until they only had, like, 16. They would only permanently have 16 pictures on their Instagram account, right?
Right.
And they would all be the best ones. But Instagram realized, okay, that's not good for us, because if you constantly just have very few pictures, that's less of an opportunity for us to slip an old Adderoo in there.
Yeah.
Also, Snapchat is fucking blowing up. So let's go ahead and just take what Snapchat does, which is encourage oversharing, because you're not watching things in one line, right? You're just hitting a button saying, no, I want to see 14 things, some of them videos, some of them pictures, from this one person.
Hey, so it was Grant Thompson that got me started on it, but it occurred to me, I don't think you saw, like, we finally released the big thing. Did you the King of Random? You didn't see this blowing up coconuts shit that we did.
I did not. I haven't seen blowing up coconuts. Can we see it?
All right, yeah. All right, hold on. Let me figure out our shot. Nope. Not that one. Yep. Okay. Yeah, that'll work. Actually, that'll be better. So, we look like...
So you guys, this is daily stuff. So you guys shot like a week's worth of stuff while he was there in Austin.
Yeah. Yeah. And it looks like this one's doing even bigger. But here, we could maybe do a kind of a breakdown. Let me see if I can...
You guys do look like cousins.
Yeah. I never realized that until this moment. You see the thumbnail, and I'm like, oh my god, we're the same person. Here,
please. You guys ready to do this? You might remember this guy. This is Brian Brushwood with The Modern Rogue. Link's in the description so you can go check out his channel. And we're back today testing out whether or not you can actually make a grenade with a coconut.
It's cold, we're semi-protected, we have a blast shield, and we got coconuts.
I kind of didn't tell Mom and Dad what we were up to, just sort of like, hey, can we shoot some stuff?
Oh, so this
Saturday?
this is at your parents' place down the road.
Yeah.
And so you're like, yo, me and my buddy, after we made butter, quote unquote, now we're gonna bust some nuts in your backyard.
Yes.
What coconuts look like in Texas.
All right, hang on. Don't judge Texas by our coconuts.
Everybody knows that moldy coconuts are a delicacy here, all right?
So back when I was growing up, there was a movie called Swiss Family Robinson.
Yeah, sure. The Disney classic.
It's a 1960s movie about a family that got shipwrecked on an island. They got invaded by pirates, and the way that they defended themselves was by making these coconut grenades and throwing them over the edges. So they basically used black powder, coconut shells, and I imagine banana leaves to make the fuses, and they made these improvised explosives. So do they actually work? The purpose of this experiment today is to find out whether or not you can actually use a coconut to make a grenade. This isn't an experiment we would recommend trying at home. That's why we're not trying it at my home. We're trying it at Brian's.
And we're not telling you how we do it either.
By the way, man, that was another moment when I had to write the folks in the Slack. I'm like, man... Grant can cite chapter and verse of the YouTube terms of service for all this stuff. I was like, we should probably read it at least once. Like, he knows exactly what he can and can't get away with. I don't know why when I pan over here it does that. Oh, well.
Either. These fuses have dried out overnight. They become pretty stiff and rigid, and we've done a couple of tests, and they do look promising. They burn a little bit faster than we were expecting, right?
Oh, my gosh. Lightning fast. We're going to run fast.
Now, one thing that's a little bit unfortunate is most of the coconuts we got were young, and you can tell that because these ones are white. Now he's black and white. I want you to look at the face of that coconut. You can see two eyes and a mouth.
Yep, yep.
Now I want you to just take that screwdriver and show us how difficult it is to burrow through the mouth.
Oh, jeez! I did not expect that. Man, I was thinking we need a drill or some nonsense.
Now, in contrast, why don't you try poking that through one of the eyes?
Oh, jeez.
Not happening.
Oh, really? Oh, wow. I had no idea.
So see, guys, I wouldn't lie to you.
Coconut knowledge, people.
He says, oh, I'm so sorry. I don't know what I did to deserve it.
So update, guys. We got our coconuts prepped and ready. All we have to do now is stick in a fuse and light them off. This one has little. This one has more.
This one is just right.
Which one is going to make the biggest effect? What do you think? Little?
Dude, more? That one that I'm holding is just full. Just full on full of...
It's full... Wait, of what did you have in it?
We don't even say on this. I think he says black powder or whatever. It's a muzzle loading powder. It's a black powder replacement that is a smokeless powder that burns real good.
Or most. Put your comments down below and let us know.
Here, let me
try. You know what's so cold out here? My lips are freezing.
Yeah,
they're freezing up. So we rigged up the fuse here. We got the paper fuse that may or may not burn super fast, and we've got sugar fuse taped to it as well. So this will give us quite a bit of burn time, we hope. So we're starting off with the smallest charge. We're going to set this thing in, get behind our blast shield, and just see how the first reaction does.
I'm ready.
So you've been here.
All right.
You've been here, yeah. So this is just outside of my dad's barn, and I'm seriously thinking about like whether or not we're just going to clang the sides and dent it. And there might have been a burn ban going on at the time, and I had to think like, well, we're not really burning things, we're just
really.
Yeah, no, I definitely we you can see everything soaking wet because I spent like 30 minutes hosing everything down just to be safe.
Just to make sure that you weren't immediately setting up a brush fire that took your parents home.
Yeah, a little bit.
So is this going to work? This is our smallest charge, so let's light this thing off and see how it does.
Flash shield. Please don't be the last thing I ever see. Oh, holy God. Wow.
That's wow. I think that was a quarter cup.
A small one. Okay, I'm glad we have a blast shield.
That thing ricocheted and like just about hit my face. That was amazing.
A small one.
Wow. Oh Jesus Christ.
Right? It was like some Mythbusters shit, only with none of the safety precautions because we're idiots. It's like we're wearing these welding masks. That's plastic up top. That's not gonna save our eyes.
Full on shrapnel.
I saw pieces flying probably at least a good 20 feet there. Yeah. You know what? I'm starting to think that there's some viability to the whole coconut grenade idea.
I wouldn't want to be standing in the way of one.
Wow, let's check out the damage. Where's the coconut?
It's completely vaporized.
So your thoughts and impressions on that, Mr. Brushwood?
I was uncomfortable with those projectiles.
What were you guys shooting this on?
Say what?
What were you guys shooting this on?
He's got like his 4K camera that he's got like on, you know, what do they call them? Gorilla legs, whatever. Joby,
like more than monopod, or
yeah. And so, you know, his style is just, you know, so super run and gun. Like some of it was shot, some of the slow mo was shot on his phone because he's able to get 240 frames per second on the slow mo on there. But I mean, you know, he's cracked the code on what works on YouTube for sure.
This one has twice as much of the charge this one did. So is it going to be a bigger explosion or is it going to be less of an explosion? Coconut grenade number two. Let's have at it.
All right, I'm ready to do the honors.
Jackie Moon says it looked like you guys were going to kiss.
Oh,
we're going to kiss.
No. Well, we were going to, but then, you know, we leaned in and he put his fingers over my lips and just said, "I'm sorry, Brian, 12-year-olds, it's against the terms of service."
We're live.
There he goes.
Oh my God!
So this one, you can actually see the unburnt powder fling around on it. Oh, let me see. Like, look at that. That's all unburnt powder that's being flung on fire.
Wow! So it exploded at such a ferocity that even the ignitable element was being thrown away from it.
Correct. And all I'm thinking of is like, you know, embers everywhere. And, you know, because like stuff was flying up. Oh, after that first one, Jay comes out and he's clearly uncomfortable. He's like, hey, guys, I found coconut in the pool. Are you sure this is where you want to do this? And it's like, meanwhile, it's just like, we've come this far. Ain't no going back.
Oh, wow. I mean, that's looking more and more like a real grenade, man.
Dude, you know what? My impression is, like, we probably used more powder than necessary.
Yeah.
Because, like, there's so much still left behind. But the power that shell blasted out with was really impressive.
So I don't know where all the shrapnel went.
This one flew about 20 feet away. It smells like toasted coconut.
Oh, it's still warm.
Should we try? Is it warm?
Oh, there's still parts of it. We still got bits of powder in there. I wonder if that's because like it's a little bit too moist, so it didn't burn completely. Ooh.
Tastes like coconut.
So our next one actually has double that amount of power. We're going to call this one Big Bertha.
Oh, yeah, I see uncomfortable-ass Jay in the background there.
Oh, you did. I missed him. All right.
That amount of power.
that's Max.
No, who is that?
That's Max. Yeah, Max helped us out on the shoot.
Bertha.
Yeah, we call this one Brian hides behind the blast shield. Tell me how it goes. It's going.
Like, do you see like all the other ones were like exploded in all directions? This one had so much force it just shot. In all directions.
Oh, dude, I felt the repercussion for that.
That was like an electric shock. It was like a thunderclap right in front of us.
Whoa!
Is that amazing?
That would have been deadly! Like, if we were right there, that's ripping arm off
you
energy
see how
right there.
The shrapnel, like, flies out completely horizontally.
Yeah,
like,
no, there's none of this jaunty up it comes and down it falls. This is just like, out of my way, I'm killing people.
Okay, so yes, bigger is better.
Bigger is bigger.
Well, guys, that's all we were able to find in 5 minutes of search.
Get ready. You want to see my favorite part?
I think so. Mm-hmm. So you're stranded on a deserted island battling pirates. It might be a good option to have.
Yeah, you could just raid your cannons for the powder. You can use banana leaves to make the fuses. Use the coconuts. I don't know how you make a blast shield, though.
King of Random, you're an agent of chaos!
Super cool hanging out with you guys today, and a big thanks to you, Brian Brushwood.
Yeah, man, join us over at the Modern Rogue channel. We're doing all kinds of stuff like...
Look at that giant ass button.
Shit, I bet you people are gonna accidentally click on it.
Oh, wait, I meant to click... Oh, wait! Oh, I clicked on the live update. Oh, gosh. All right.
This. So I got his links in the description below. If you like the stuff we're doing here, you're probably going to like the stuff that he's doing over there as well. So go check him out.
High five.
Yeah.
That was good stuff.
And high fives to you guys. We'll see you in the next experiment. Talk to you then.
Man, I'll tell you what.
I really can't talk.
I know. It's cold.
I have a family, please.
He's cracked that code, man. He knows what YouTube wants.
Well, and he's just got that perfect way of editing it where it, like, it feels like just him on his phone, but he has, like, that persistent, you know, adventure audio in the background, and all the editing is like, clean but not over flashy. Like, it's all kind of meat. There's not a whole lot of, like, you know, just super silly, like, kind of side jag stuff. It's all, like, related to the experiment. Like, it just feels like there's a very fun experiment there.
Yeah. Well, and he managed to, like, there was one video, we were even talking about this. He's got that one video where it was like he made this thing to cut styrofoam that makes a red hot wire and you push the styrofoam around in it. And the question is like, well, what happens when a red hot wire hits dry ice? And it was somebody in the chat or in the comments had asked. And he was like, all right, well, let's find out. And the answer is nothing. Literally jack shit happens. You touch it and the wire cools down instantly and you can't really do anything. And it just in every way was a massive, massive failure. How many views do you think you got?
Seven people and all seven. And then there were 8 comments, ironically, that were all from different people saying you suck and you're a disappointment.
How many views do you think you got?
4.
You're almost right.
Okay.
If you were thinking,
nailed it. Oh, I'm the best. I nailed it.
If you were thinking 4 million, but
oh
you.
Oh my God.
But you would have been short by another 1.4 million.
Oh, jeez.
Raptors YZ left a comment asking whether or not the styro slicer could cut through dry ice. And I'm actually not really sure what would happen if we tried. So I got out my styro slicer and I went and picked up some dry ice. So today.
So, and then he just does it.
Enough heat to easily
he tries it, cranks
the
up the heat to full. Like and the answer is the ice yeah, just cools it off too fast. And it doesn't do anything.
A large and cold mass so, battling against.
No!
Right, exactly. Nothing is the answer. And then. and then,
Excuse you.
5 million views. Bada bing bang.
Wow.
It's,
I mean, like, maybe that's just. Like, that's algorithm plus, like.
Wait, but plus also genuinely having a gift for asking the question or responding to the questions that people want to know. Like, how do you read that title and not click to find out? And plus, you know, he's not going to overstay his welcome. It's going to be three to 5 minutes long. He'll be pleasant and you'll get the visuals that you want. You'll get an understanding of why it doesn't work. If it doesn't work, he'll try another idea and get you to a place. I mean, dude's cracked the code. I mean, there's it's perfect too because you know he's got a million like father son combinations watching all of his stuff every morning before school. Like, oh good, there's another King of Random video.
Yeah, because he's 5 days a week.
Mm-mm.
No,
every day.
Day.
7 days a week. Day.
How long is he? How is he ahead episodes? Like, how far is he ahead episodes? Like, I mean, you got to figure that's like, He's shooting and editing every day. That's the life he lives.
TV's Egon either just got busted at work or just got bored of us because he just hung up. I don't know. I don't want to speak out of turn for him, but I know that he's very aware that like whatever's happening now is extraordinary, and you know, you don't mess with that. If the algorithm wants every day, he'll figure out a way to do it every day. You know.
Dude, well, I mean, hell, it's working for him, right? He's like, he's cranking it. What is his subscriber count at?
Let's look at it real time. Oh, that'll be interesting. So right now, I am enjoying.
Oh, Zach Holder in the chat. What's up?
Zach Holder, DJ.
This is BB Live Show.
Oh man, this is great. So like right now, we got a giant plug on a popular video. It's gonna blow past 1 million views. Right now we're on track to have our biggest day, ever on the Modern Rogue. Let's see what happens when I go the King of Random real time. So we're doing about 500 or 600 an hour. Get ready. All right, hold on.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah. Right. Oh, haha. Oh, people are trying to affect it.
That's insane, man. And how long, things did you guys shoot while you were out there?
We got five. The first one that got released was us trying to make butter faster than toast could get made. And we played that last night. And then we did the making black powder fuses. And then we did blowing up the coconuts. And then we... Well, that's interesting. So I guess he's big enough now that the phenomenon of people seeing his stuff and being like, eh, I'm out, happens to him. Like, we haven't really experienced that with...
that he's got such a saturation that now...
The mere act of releasing...
accumulation, like, unsubscribers are something that's noticeable statistically?
Yeah, or at least part of the noise, right? Like, if you're this much, you gotta have, like, 20,000 unsubscribes, you know, compared to the 200,000 subscribes every month.
Dude, that's fucking insane, man. How are you feeling now that, like, you know, Modern Rogue? I mean, we were looking at some numbers behind the scenes, but like, not only is Modern Rogue on a crazy trajectory, right? But it's already kind of in very key metrics, like money outperforming like Scam School. Like, how does that feel?
It's so brief and ephemeral right now that I'm cautious, you know, like I don't want to just decide this is the new normal, because if you look at the thing, as a matter of fact, let me do Modern Rogue here. You could see, here we go, that while we had a very I'll show this is all public stuff. If you go to socialblade.com, you can see all this stuff. But so you could see that we had, you know, we were doing our sleepy 250 subscribers a day. And then the algorithm smiled upon us, and the best we did was in one day we did 10,600, and we got a lot of views. And then it kind of filtered on down back to doing this 1,000 a day.
And so do you think that was algorithm plus the one video that did catch fire?
Yes, absolutely. Well, I mean, I think it was all that video per the algorithm liking it and sending it over. But then now...
Oh, by the way, Night Attack in the chat room, which is our illustrious producer, Bryce Neshkamp Castillo. Apparently, there is the phrase "algorithm smiling" is something that is being said a lot around the office these days.
Oh yeah, no, I mean that's what I describe it, right? Like, you know, the YouTube, I guess I could say the YouTube gods. But
I also think that that it does just sound like a Peter F. Hamilton novel, though, right? Like,
algorithm smiles upon
Peter
you.
F. Hamilton.
Oh, this is interesting. Yearly projections, if every month was like this one, we'd be at over 1 million, but I don't think that'll happen. I think we're going to regress to the mean. But so you could see like we had the initial rush, we had sleepy time, and then we had the algorithm rush, And then now we're having the King of Random rush on. Again, these are all subs. The views, though, is what worries me. It's like we had a lot of views, although this isn't accurate. Like, these days aren't shown here, and then it plays catch-up. So really, it's just kind of went up here and then back. But
that was you had the one video that went like cray cray.
Yeah, correct. But anyway, to your point, like, it's really exciting for this exact moment this month. Modern Rogue is doing fantastic. It's outperforming Scam School by a lot. But do I believe it's going to be that way forever? Absolutely not. You know, that's part of the reason that I want so much to try to seduce as many folks into my creepy van as possible.
Is that how you envision Modern Rogue? Is your creepy windowless industrial van,
yeah,
driving around,
like,
the,
hey,
internet looking
in
to lure as many people as possible?
Hey man, come on in. We're talking about beer. Don't you want to learn how beer is made?
Oh, we got the, yeah, beers. Hey, we're blowing something up in my garage. Do you want to come into my windowless van?
Yeah, man.
Yeah, hey, we're learning how to do push-ups. You want to take off your shirt and come into my van?
I tell you that brand. I don't even want to show it.
Say it.
There's blackmail footage of me with my shirt off, doing push-ups and whatnot.
We were doing BB Live show. That was one of the, for a lot of people who didn't see BB Live show, one of our favorite bits on BB Live show was Brian shirtless doing pushups. Mother, like, that was something that everybody loved. Everybody was.
I didn't do it shirtless.
It was shirtless Brian doing pushups. It was a classic. Everybody who remembers that classic bit, just write it down in the chat room. Classic bit, love it. I'm glad it's back. Just, you know, because it was a great time. It was
killing me.
Something. Everyone's going great. All these hardcore BB Live show fans remember the classic bit of shirtless Brian doing push-ups.
God damn. No, I can't even.
Yeah. Hey, thanks for the sub, DC 55222.
Yeah. So anyway, I was saying, like, to put in perspective, Grant, you know, took a photo earlier today and now it has 6,500 likes on Instagram. And then Brant replies, you could have just posted this if you wanted 6,500 likes on Instagram. And it's a not flatter. Here, I'll let you see.
Let's go. Come on.
Oh,
damn.
That's
it's getting hot as hell in here. Keep going.
No.
Keep going.
No. No.
Come on.
I will not do that to you guys.
You saw those sweet nips, and we need more, baby. We need more than them nips.
Nope.
What needs to happen for us to see the whole thing? To see the whole enchilada? What needs? Name your price. We're willing to pay it right now.
There is none.
Also, Bryce is threatening to dox you. Right now.
Like, what, just leak it?
Listen, I was a trained journalist. I'm going to call my sources and see if I could just get it texted to me.
No!
Hold on, I have sources. Hold on, wait a minute. I'm gonna call my sources.
Who's your source?
I'm gonna call my I have sources.
Right. Better be your mom.
All right, I'm calling my sources. I'm a journalist.
Hey, what's going on?
Hey, man. This is a secret source call. I'm doing some reporting, and I want to know if you can send me that sweet shirtless.
I want to make sure you can hear this, Bryce. The answer is no.
Not
tell
Bryce.
No.
It's an anonymous source. Anyway, Bryce, can you just send me the picture?
No!
This phone call never happened.
No!
Anyway, so getting back to the Jeep, like, what's up with the Jeep, man? Like, you driving it around all over town?
Without my shirt.
Wait, so where did that come from?
We did a thing on the push-up program. That's this Friday's episode of The Modern Rogue.
Damn. Oh, wait. Oh, so that's not up yet.
Yeah, correct. That's why that's why poor Brant had to sit there looking at everything. Although he did send today. Check this out. This is pretty cool. If you go to radio.garden, I guess / live.
Oh, it's like a visualization of radio stations around the world.
Yeah, where do you want to go?
Oh, let's go to either Berlin or Des Moines.
Well, I know where Des Moines is. I can't find Berlin on the map. Here, Des Moines is right around here.
Is Des Moines there?
Why didn't he go to Bethlehem itself then?
At that time, Christianity was forbidden. Yes. And they were,
nope,
you know,
that's Canada.
You are actually jeopardized your life. You might be killed, persecuted. Yeah.
It's a love without it. Everything comes back to. Oh, wait, Brian, wait, we should do like a virtual road trip.
All right, where do you want to go?
Well, yeah, you got to get one of us has to get on camera because we're like driving.
Oh, yeah, yeah, hold on. Let me real quick. All right, here, let me get us on cam. Sit tight.
Yeah, I'm sorry I'm neglecting you, DC 37159.
All right, here we go.
Oh, man, we're here in Lincoln Beach. Well, we need to get the fuck to New York City. I mean, to Vancouver. So let's start driving north, Brian.
Wait, hold on. Where are you? I was going to have you drive to me. There, that's...
Oh, I'm in the bay.
Is that the bay?
Yeah.
Exacto, Olimpia. Is anybody speak English there? Here, let's go to your exact house. What's that address again?
How about we don't? There's another person who lives with me that gets very upset when I give away our address.
Well, here, this one's pretty close. Kicking Country 105, right?
That is. This is my favorite radio station.
Actually, hold on. Berkeley Liberation Radio. That's where
you
live.
Yes, finally.
Oh.
Oh, no, no, we're not going to be liberated, Brian.
There you go.
That's actually Colleen's house. That's literally what's happening in Colleen. Colleen's running her own pirate radio station.
All right, so you're going to get on the highway. Which way are we going to go? Guide me.
Oh, man. All right, we're gonna head east. We're going out east into the desert because we got to get to Brian's. Oh, man, I'm so excited. This road trip to Brian's is the best decision I've ever made.
All right, so then you're going down south. Let's see. Oh,
yeah,
here we go.
Driving. Man, this speed of this car is amazing.
So I actually sourced quite a bit of fruit from the San Lucia Highlands. You're actually going to be tasting a wine today from
here,
San
Lucia. Here, I say head on over.
You're goddamn right, I'm going to be tasting that wine.
They nearly all were born out of polytheistic beliefs where you had gods either out of lust or out of envy or some other motive taking on a human.
Damn, is this radio station literally in this cul-de-sac?
It's from these chuds underneath the...
Hello, welcome to Chud Public Radio. My name is... And of course, joining me as always is... when you're in the Mojave, you need to get it going.
All right, here we go.
Young buck that he used to be. He's had some issues with his back of late.
Who do you think he's talking about?
To hear about Dwight Howard having back issues, because that's where...
Oh, well, here in Lake Havasu City, we only talk about Dwight Howard. That's it. All day and all night.
All right, here we go.
No, that one, it's not Chud Radio.
Here, you want to go down to Mexico?
Mediac says, what's going on here? We're going around the world in radio times.
Yeah, dude.
Join us, won't you?
Yeah, it's called Bootleg and Other People's Pirate Radio Streams.
That'll show them.
Man, I don't know where we are now. Here, let's go here.
Where next? Oh, San Antonio. Oh, that's Jeep Central.
This is Like a Prayer. Oh, wait, so this, yeah, oh, that's right, KTSA. Tonight?
Yeah, I just want you to go to Austin, and it's only Ba with the Ba.
I swear, oh, how great would that be? All right. I don't know where this is. Leander, that's up where CJ lives. Oh, this is the lake. Oh, there we go. Pure Hate Tejano. Now, do you want to listen to Tejano or alt Latino?
Oh, I want to go alt Latino. That's the racist Latino, right?
No, no. That's okay. All right. Okay. Sulla frontiera. Ci sono le cellule che controllano i rifiuti. Dude, it is. It really is. Ci spiano telecamere piazzate sui semafori. Ci seguono con radar. Ci usa per I calcoli. Controllano le cose che guardiamo alla parabola. Eppure non mi sono mai sentito così libero. Eppure non mi sono mai sentito così libero. Perché io danzo. Perché io danzo. Sulla frontiera. Perché io danzo.
Man, this one's toe tapping.
Yeah,
huh?
Man, that's fucking great. Let's see. Do you want to drive all the way out to Orlando?
Let's go to Bass Drop, baby.
All right, here we go. Let's we can stop in Houston.
Shit, man. Here in Houston, we like to chill out. Unlike you big bad city folks, we like to let it flow a little bit in H-Town. Sorry to see you go, DC 37159.
Who?
DC 37159. He's gotta go.
Oh,
so I'm wishing him a good
so
eve.
So long. All right, let's go straight to Miami. What do you think we're gonna hear? Is that Miami?
No, that's not. Miami's on the East Coast. There we go. That big old cluster there.
We're funded by WLRN members and by dishes.
Oh,
for dogs,
that was my jam, son.
Was it
WLRN Public Radio? That's really my shit.
Oh, that's amazing. What about
yes, that was my local, my local NPR station on the media? Yeah, I got that. This American Life about it. Download a show in 4 seconds and buffering isn't a worry. Finally. Where the most popular sport is mixed Martian arts. Zarnik takes Cleef to the mat. And microchips come in salt and vinegar.
Did I show you that that shortwave radio tool? Did you play with that at all?
Oh, wait, is this the one where you could translate pictures with audio?
Well, no. So if you go to shortwave.
Yeah, everybody put your local NPR in the chat room. I want to know everybody's local NPR. We're going to be really hip. Brian, we're on a very young platform with all the kids, so we're going to identify all of our local NPR stations so we're going to be hip with the kids.
Oh, that's good. If you want to impress everyone with your local hip kid stuff, you know what the kids are into. It's shortwave radio. So this is a university in like Amsterdam or something, but they've got this tool that lets you go through the whole spectrum of shortwave transmissions, and like some of them like play for a little bit and then stop. For example, like here, we'll tune in over here. You know, we'll kind of zoom in.
Are any chat room? If you're in a chat room right now and you can hear the tone of my voice, then write whatever you want. Write your local NPR station.
But like you can actually see, we were able to catch a number station live a while ago.
Oh shit, really?
Yeah, it was fucking awesome. But there's this chat here. In the chat, people are all like, hey, number station, because they're on like set schedules, and it says number station coming up in 5 minutes over at this. And then we tuned in, and it was, and sure enough, it was fucking number station. It was awesome.
Do we? All right. So I know we've talked about number stations a lot. Do we? I mean, like, is it drug thing or is it?
Oh, no. I always thought it was an espionage thing where it's like you had agents in the field who needed their marching orders. And so they had a one way pad. And so they tune in their shortwave. The whole world hears the numbers, but it only means something to the one agent.
The person who has the cipher, right?
Yeah, exactly, right?
Wait, do people not know what number stations are?
Oh, dude.
Who knows what a number station is?
You guys can't wait. You can't hear me? You can't hear the music.
Oh, you can't hear the shortwave radio.
Like, there's one. Oh, get this. Let me see what it is. Sorry, Kid Rock. Let's see. The buzzer.
It's like, oh, I'm sorry. I got my sidearm with me. You know, just bowing the ball whenever we need it.
Yeah, so UVB-76 is called the buzzer, and it's at 4625 kilohertz, right? Uh-huh. So check this out. We're going to go there right now, and then I'm going to...
By the way, have we become Ham Nation? Become Ham Nation?
Maybe, but look at this. So do you hear that? You hear that buzzing, right?
Yeah.
It is rumored, like, people have listened to that. It is buzzed nonstop for dozens of years. And there are times people can hear voices and talking on there, too. And it's thought that that's not a computer-generated buzz. It is thought that that is a Russian military, an actual room with an actual buzzer hooked up to an actual microphone, and that that is a dead man's switch. And at the moment that stops buzzing, it means this place has fallen. Nuke everything.
Oh my God! Right?
Is that insane?
All right. Yeah. Welcome to Coast with Bri and Whiskers. Brian, you know they call me Whiskers because I'm curious like a cat. Moving on.
Yeah, dude, it was cool finding the number station, and then there are some with like slow scan television that are transmitting like images of various varieties. But this is a freaking cool tool.
So wait, what is this again?
It's you go to shortwave.themodernrogue.com and it forwards you to this tool. These guys have a shortwave, like a really nice antenna, and it's a software-based tuner, so multiple people can tune in to different things at the same time. They record everything on all spectrums, and you could dial in on any of it. Like here, you see these things that are kind of coming and going? These are transmissions that are stopping and starting.
That's amazing.
Right? And then you'll find some, what do you call it? Some... Here we go.
Come on down to old grandpa's fun shack.
We've got pinstripes. Dial SOS to save 20%.
Wanna pull, Weevil? Give us your numbers on the number station. That is a pretty sick beat. R&R asks if I have any love advice. I will solve your love. Whiskers and Bri will solve your love problems. All you gotta do is call in. Where are we telling people to call in?
Night Attack show right now.
Night
Give
Attack
us a call.
Show.
Oh wait, hang on. Look, there's even a thing. I can. No. Yep. Nope. Nope. Hold on. Nope. That's not even right. Here, let me type in the right one.
Yeah, NSFW show.
Night Attack show.
Dog Weasel says it sounds like Darude Sandstorm. No, he's already on Twitch.
Is he?
Oh yeah, no, he's like a huge guy.
All right, that's enough. He's fat. Is that what you're saying?
He got fat, man. He's like, look. Turns out the Sandstorm was a burger storm for me. I ate all of them.
And then the Sandman came.
Oh, Night Attack show, not NSFW show.
Yeah,
Night
no, I fixed it. I fixed it. We got it. So what about you, man? What's big in your world?
Oh, apparently there's a do-do-do-do-do emote because Darude is so popular on Twitch. I was informed by somebody. Man, you know, this week has just been so weird. I mean, obviously, like, just the like, expanding into Twitch thing has just been, you know, time-consuming, right? Because we want to try, you know, and failed to do everything as smoothly as possible.
I'll tell you what, man. We're old pros at this compared to BB Live Show days. BB Live Show days, we'd get an hour out of just framing a thing, like just moving a thing to the right spot.
No, so literally pre-show, back in the day when we would walk uphill both ways to school, like literally the pre-show, number one, there was no show. There was just getting the show ready. Brian wanting company while he was getting the show ready.
Yep.
Then there was live, which was also another hour of getting the show ready, doing something, and then just ending the stream after we were all tired, right?
Yeah,
that's really where the Dirk's rule really came in, was just it's like, all right, yeah, the party's over when you go three videos in a row and nobody's talking.
Yeah.
But yeah, no. So, I mean, like that holiday shipping, because you guys are smart. You guys have evolved at Scam Stuff and have a fulfillment center and everything.
Oh, you're scrambling.
Yeah.
Lord, everyone knows Justin's a scrambling man.
So yeah, you know, like there was just that. And then, you know, coming back, we're going to Ohio on Friday for Christmas. So it's just been a lot. And then also I'll say this, and this is not going to earn me any pity, and nor should it, but it's like Monday night, old Go Game acquaintance was in town and I was going to go get a drink with her. And then she's like, oh, I'm still at the Go Game party. The Go Game had their Christmas party on Monday night. Like, normally, at a Christmas party, you go and you drink, you get to know your coworkers, everybody gets a chance to, you know, cut loose a little bit, and that's that. And they did. It was a great time. But, like, she's like, oh, everything's still going at this holiday party at, like, 8. Do you want to just come out here to the holiday party? And I'm like, okay. It's a Monday night holiday party. Things are going to be wrapping up in the next hour. We'll go and just pick up a drink after that. And we'll you know, BS. No. This party is, like, lit. People are just, like, hanging from the chandeliers, just getting wild, like, you know, pouring booze on each other. Like, it is, like, it's a great party on Monday. Now, that's fine. Because, I mean, again, we pretty much do the stuff that we do, right?
Yeah,
it's
I got
a boss yelling at me.
Go game plays hard. They work hard. They play hard, right?
So the only problem is that, like, because I've tried to take this stuff a lot more seriously, especially over the last few months, I've gotten myself on a bit of a schedule. And I have stuff to do before noon. Like, I normally wake up at 6. I'm out for a run by 6:45 to 7 o'clock. I'm back here, showered, dressed. Like, I'm focusing on whatever the 10 o'clock morning podcast is by, you know, 8:30, something like that.
Right.
That can't happen if I'm up until 2 o'clock in the morning, like, just going hard with all these Go Game people.
Oh, so you had an old man jury moment. You're just like, all right, now, hold on. Some of us can't stay up past 10 p.m.
Oh, no, that's what I was thinking. And then I stayed up until 2 o'clock in the morning, and I woke up and tried to pour myself into the fairly aggressive morning schedule
Did you go for your run?
Without having any of the previous sleep.
Did you go for your run?
I walked.
You got out the door, though. That's huge.
Oh, no. That's the rule. The rule is every day, it's like, hey, listen, I can either run, and it can take a half hour, or I can walk, and it'll take 45 minutes to 50 minutes.
Yep.
So it's like, If I want to just keep my day on schedule, I can run. But, like, if it's just not going to happen, then it ain't going to happen. And that was what that was. But it also is just like, man, adding that on top of everything else this week has just been like, oh, geez, just nuts. Just like, Just burning the candle at both ends kind of thing. Do we have a radiator? No. That dude just left? Our radiator got stolen.
Wait, from your house?
Yeah, homeboy rolled on in and said, "Got your ass," and just stole the radiator.
Well, for reals, pinky promise?
I mean, as far as we know, it's supposed to be fixed. Instead, they just rolled in, took it, and then never came back.
Right on.
And that's where we're at right now, is like we literally just don't have a radiator, except like the guy seemed like he was a legit plumber. Like he had an appointment with our superintendent.
I mean, what's the value of a radiator, right? Like radiator's like stealing a cooking pan, right? It's just a cast of a thing and that's it.
Oh damn. Odakta's in Diamond Chat. Odakta, call in.
Night Attack show.
Come on. And then we'll call Brett.
Yeah. No. I'll have to set up the quad laser again. Poop Tempest. It's a good name. So you're on the hunt for a radiator.
So, I mean, well, like, what the fuck am I supposed to do without a radiator if it gets cold? We're just going to huddle up in blankets? Is that what we're supposed to do?
I mean, if it gets cold, wait, wouldn't you just get in the studio's got to stay warm forever, right? Because you have all them computers.
Oh, crap. So we just sleep? We just sleep in the studio?
Yeah.
Like, under...
I mean, didn't it used to be your bedroom?
It did. This used to be where all the magic happened. you know?
Maybe the...
palming... Huh?
You can
French drops?
Wait, French drops palming. Magic, man.
Do you need heat in Oakland? Nah, man, look up. Like it's getting a little chilly out here in old Oaklandia these days. It's a little chilly. It's a little chilly.
Yeah. All right, look, man, I don't want to call it early, but I think I'm in charge of the kids, and I ain't heard from them for a bit. Let me look and see if Bonnie's car's back or not.
Okay, I'll just talk to the chat. Hey, why don't we do a little thing we used to do called rapid fire?
Oh shit, rapid fire! All right, here, yeah, you do this. I'm gonna
do it both chats. So wherever you are, just give me a yes or no question. I will answer all of them as we go along. So that's if you've never played rapid fire, I will answer as many yes or no questions as we absolutely can.
All right, ready?
All right, here we go.
Set.
Anytime now.
Hold on here. I was gonna.
I mean, again, it's yes or no questions, folks. Come on. How many?
Nope, there it is. There it is. Cake or pie. All
right, here we go. Cake or pie. Pie.
Dude, you're owning it. You're killing it.
Do you remember the Crossfire game jingle commercial? Crossfire, yes, of course. K-pop or popcorn? Popcorn. Fisting or fingering? Oaklandite or Oaklandian? Oaklandian. Red Hot Chili Peppers or the Beatles? The Beatles. California or Florida? California.
Thank you.
Are you planning a Midwest tour? I'm doing another In Your House tour. I don't know where it's going to be yet. So yes and no. Do you like 21 Pilots? No. What smells worse, Diesel Fuel or Vin Diesel? Diesel Fuel, Twitch or DCTV? All. Hitler or Pol Pot? None. Boobs or butts? Boobs. Bourbon or scotch? Bourbon. Dish TV or Comcast? Comcast. Indica or Sativa? Whichever's the one that like makes you just sit on a couch and not be productive. I forget which one is which. Steak fries or fried fries? Steak fries. Remember the Death Star? Yeah, I know. I just watched a movie that made sure I did. Grapefruit or watermelon? Watermelon. Clickbait or no clickbait? Clickbait. It gets a lot of my friends paid. Star Trek TOS or TNG? TNG. Is this a question? No. Taylor Swift or Taylor Guitar? Taylor Swift, Shake It Off. Battlefield or COD? Neither. Lubed or unlubed? Lubed. Dick or vagina? Vagina. Jason Murphy or Jason Hell? Trick question. They're the same person. Star Trek or Stargate? Star Trek. McDonald's or Burger King? Wendy's. Shake it once or twice? Three times. A lady. Rogue One or Attack of the Clones? Rogue One. Bong or blunt? Bong. Just more cost effective. A walk to school or carry your lunch? Do both, right? Whataburger or Chick-fil-A? Trump or mittens? Mittens. Titties or balls? Titties. Tits or ass? Tits. Jesus, guys. Rogue One or Westworld? Westworld. Star Quest or Star Battle? One of those is fake, I'm pretty sure. I'm going to go with Star Battle anyway. Mighty Taco or Dinosaur Barbecue? Always Dinosaur Barbecue. Always Dinosaur Barbecue. Never Jury Talks or never PX3 anymore? I could stand to never do PX3 anymore. It would make me sad, but Jury Talks is just an expression of my life at this point. Westworld or Mr. Robot? Mr. Robot. Teleportation or Replication? Teleportation. Samurai Showdown or Street Fighter? Street Fighter. Yes or no? No. Stout or Porter? Stout. Wine or Pod? Wine. Kirk or Picard? Picard. Robotech or SDF Macros? SDF Macros. Stranger Things or The Thing? Stranger Things. Vanilla or Chocolate Milkshake? Chocolate Milkshake. Stargate or Star Surge? That's three and three quarter stars. Star Surge. Is this chart even working? I don't know that. Is the end of Rapid Fire. I have no idea if Brian is back or not. I was hoping that at some point there'd be some Brian cackling, but whatever, we'll keep going. King Kong or Godzilla? Godzilla. DC TV or Frog Pants? Those are the same thing. No shower or bath or no radiator? I'll take no radiator. A Better Day to Kardashian hugging a toaster in a filled bathtub? The bathtub. Am I having a seizure yet? No. Black or red licorice? Red licorice. Andrew Mayne or Brian Brushwood? Andrew Mayne used to pay me. Billy Fusillo or Billy Zane? Billy Fusillo.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Used to pay you.
He did.
All right.
I mean, like, we split money.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, you're right. Because now it's Andrew doesn't pay. Andrew ain't your boss. He ain't your boss, man.
No, he ain't the boss to me. Here's a few that we didn't get to: Harambe or Cecil the Lion. Brian, where would you go, Harambe or Cecil the Lion?
Harambe. It's got to be Harambe.
Did you ever see that picture that the Cincinnati Zoo didn't want you to see? It's a pretty good picture. Are you looking to get food? What do you want to get? Are you just talking to me while I'm on the stream? Yeah. This is great. Why don't you pick up a mic and be part of the show?
There it is. God, we have gotten endless joy out of this.
That picture, Brian and I have just sent to each other, trying to sneak shot it to each other so many times. It's so good. Man, I'll tell you what. Life is funny, huh?
Yeah.
What is that dead man switch frequency again? Ask Captain Fubar.
Just type up the buzzer shortwave, and I believe, yeah, it's called UVB76, and it is 4625 kilohertz. And you can go to shortwave a dot themonorogue.com. Yeah, see here.
By the way, I think our radiator's back. I think that dude was like fucking jarred loose by us talking all sorts of shit on the internet.
That motherfucker. Is it just
so what you played was live. That was it live.
Yeah.
This is like a recording of it.
Yeah.
But we heard it live.
Yeah. Correct. Hey, how do you think the world's gonna end?
Um So by the world, we mean no more human life on Earth, right? Or do we mean like Earth dying and
I think you're right. Life. Human life on Earth, I'll say. Yeah.
So the question is, because now
by the way, Beef Viper pipes in saying runaway greenhouse effect. And I think there's virtually no chance of that. Not that there won't be a runaway effect, but that you better believe if this shit's threatening third quarter profits, engineers will start spraying reflective aerosols to cool things off real fast.
Yeah, that's like one of those things that's always kind of weird is we always like imagine the unchecked possibility of what's going to happen on something, mm-hmm. but never like the years and years it will take like to really start affecting things. Like there was always this bit that they used to do on Opie and Anthony where they made fun of because periodically there'd be like these like stories of like, oh, when New York floods and all the like infographics would have like cars and stuff and like, you know, garbage trucks just like in this submerged Atlantean like kind of a world as if all the water got dumped on New York like at once and nobody had a chance, like it was just one big rainstorm and that was it. I think that there's really like one thing we're good at, humans, and that's like living. We're pretty good at avoiding death.
Well, Pendulette says like he's so atheist he doesn't even believe believers actually believe. And his point is like if you truly believed that anyone who didn't accept Jesus Christ in your soul is going to burn in hell, then you would literally hold them down and spit loogies in their eyes until they finally admitted that they accept Christ. Like you would go to any length to save someone. And the mere fact that people are kind of blasé, we're like, oh, well, that's just the way I am, and you're the way you are. He's like, no, if you really believed, you would be freaking out and, you know, doing literally whatever it took. I kind of feel that way with a lot of people who are convinced that environmentally we're going to hell in a handbasket, where it's like, if you truly believed that the greatest threat on the planet was runaway global warming, feel like you would have a whole... I feel like you would not be living in temperate zones. I feel like you would have already moved to Canada. I feel like you would already be stockpiling food. And the mere fact that you're not means that you probably don't really believe it.
Well, I mean, it certainly does fit into a neat little narrative about like self-loathing, though, right? Like it's definitely like, well, I mean, I know it's coming because I'm smart, but also the rest of these dummies like aren't going to do anything and I'm impotent to change it. So I'm just going to sit in my own poop and be mad. And you should read this Facebook post I'm about to write.
Yeah. Right. I mean, I guess that's just it. Like, I mean, if a train was literally about to run over your daughter, you'd not be blogging about it on Facebook. You'd not be hashtagging it like, you know, hey man, if you guys cared, you'd stop this train from running over my daughter. Like, you would have a different action if you truly believed
it. Hashtag save my daughter from the train. Hashtag killer train. Hashtag stop the trains.
Yes, exactly.
The trains run on time for death. Hashtag. Yeah, you know, how do I think it'll end? I think it'll end when we leave, and because Earth will, like, just kind of suck. It'll just be a butt place to be, and we'll just be like, man, let's just peace. Let's just get out. Hey, babe, bro, do you just want to get out of here? Just want to peace?
You know what? If we're defining the end of the world as humanity's presence on it ending, I actually think there will be a big bunch of humanity that leaves, but I think that moment will be in a fully occupied planet Earth. But it will be that moment that what occupies planet Earth is no longer recognizable as human beings. Like when we've moved on to, you know, so many implants and so many robotic parts or whatever that we've become post-human basically. So I still think there'll be plenty of people and critters all over the place, but it's like you could show that world to us today and we would say that is not the planet Earth. That is not humanity.
Yeah. No, I'm down with that. Like, we've been getting on politics into, like, I came to the conclusion, my conclusion is the biggest unlearned lesson from this election season is that globalism is something that means things to certain people, and that it meant very much something to the demographic that wound up swinging the election. And I don't think that, like, in general, I was well enough, you know, equipped to understand it, and I needed to learn more, and that was going to be part of what politics was going forward, was understanding it. And one of the most fascinating elements of it, and I don't really know how much it affected this election, but I find it fascinating, is the intersection between the idea of a one-world government being bad and the idea that in the book of Revelation that it that a universal world government and, like, marks on your hands, which can be, like, you know, be translated to microchipping or fucking wearables and shit like that, like, that all is a sign, the sign of the prophecy coming true, and that motive, I mean, who knows how many it motivates, right?
Sure.
But just that was something that multiple people wound up emailing me about was, like, fascinating to me. Like, it's one of those things where, man, we know so little about, like, how our world works and why it works, and you know, thank God we have the internet, that the ability to interact with people that we can't get around to seeing all the time exists. It doesn't mean that we do it, but we have the ability now where we didn't have the ability before. But it's just crazy.
Yeah, there's I don't know, as far as the apocalyptic visions in the Bible, there's a fantastic great courses. He's got two or three of them, and I've listened to two of them. One is the historical Jesus, and one of the things he talks about is, like, hey, man, the Bible was not written with the intention that it would make some sense to people 2,000 years in the future. You know, it was written for right then, and Jesus was preaching right then when he said, like, yeah, the world is ending, and, like, give all your shit away because it doesn't fucking matter. He meant, like, this Tuesday, like
today.
that's what everybody was hearing, was like, today that shit is not worth it.
Like, give me a dollar, because today I broke. Like, next week it's fine. I get paid on Friday. I'll have a dollar then. But right now, when we're writing the book, like, this is a documentary about a moment in time. Like, you know, for you to please understand.
Yeah. Yeah, no, it's really good. Bart Ehrman's stuff is really, really interesting.
Who's that?
That's the guy who did it. He was
Baz Luhrmann.
Bart Ehrman.
So not director of Moulin Rouge, Baz Luhrmann.
You know what? It's rumored that
that they're the same people.
I've never seen them in the same place at the same time. Let me just put that right up on front.
So you think he was, like, submitting his religious philosophy book to the publishers? It's like, hey, did you direct Moulin Rouge? Like, no,
that's
I'm Baz Luhrmann. That's my brother you're thinking of, Baz Luhrmann.
By the way, I gotta thank your girl. Fake Gamer Girl is got me hooked in a huge way to that tofu scramble. Like, I make that same recipe that she hooked up, a little bit of the liquid smoke. I'm salivating thinking about it. I take, because you know I'm doing the diet, right? I take a full onion, big old fat onion, chop, chop. I take a two... maybe one big bell pepper, celery. Maybe if I'm feeling frisky, I'll put mushrooms in there, but I always wait till the end because I don't want them to get overdone. And then I take a giant thing of, I figured out, it's not the extra firm, it's not the hard tofu, you just want firm. Firm, and it jiggles like a breast, right? It looks just like eggs, right?
We always go extra firm, but I mean, you gotta get it how you live it. However you enjoy it, is the way you gotta go.
Yeah. Well, so you you drop that in, and the one ingredient she didn't mention, that maybe it's off the menu for the way she eats, but what I do is I take chicken broth, throw it in there. And I'll break off half a cube of chicken bouillon and mix it in there. And then after that, it's the India black salt that gives it that sulfur taste.
The egg taste.
Yeah. And then a bit of the smoke, liquid smoke, and a ton of MSG. I just have a full-on thing of MSG that just every dish
just
now.
Dump it. Just make it rain.
Every dish. It's fucking great.
And lo, the MSG did fall.
Exactly. No, it's good, man. And then like this whole thing fills you up like for half the day, and it's only, you know, 400, 500 calories for just a giant bucket. Nom, nom,
nom, nom. Now, how would you describe how you initially reacted to Ashley cooking the tofu scramble? Because this was not the love affair that you have with this dish was not universal. It was certainly not love at first sight.
No, it wasn't, because I liked the taste of it.
Somebody
fine.
Just came scampering in here upon realizing what the topic of conversation is.
Yeah, no. It tasted great, but it was my first experience with tofu, and I just knew tofu was curds, which is rotten soybeans is what I thought, and I couldn't get that thought out of my head.
Joining us now on BB Live Show is my wife and the originator of the tofu scramble that Brian now salivates
swears by every single morning now, Ashley. It's like I've decided I'm gonna learn one good goddamn dish, and this is it.
Oh my goodness! Well, I'm glad that you like it now. I remember the first time that I was over there and served it up. I just remember the look on your face. Just being kind of silly, I'll put it nicely.
Generously, yeah. No. Well.
You and then you immediately went to pour yourself a bowl of cereal. That's my memory of it. Now, that person told me that you were getting into it. I just lost my shit because I'm like, how he's turned.
Yeah, there's no. All right. There is a move that Brian does because Brian in the morning and listen, you're raising three. Girls, like, your morning is very busy. I do not envy you, because when I'm over, we'll often be up until 3 o'clock in the morning doing silly, dumb stuff.
Sure,
right?
Sure.
And then you have to be up in 2.5 hours when all the girls start waking up so you can play your part in getting them out the door.
Yep.
You can catch a cat nap maybe after that, right? But you got to be up like when that happens. So
sure, yeah.
There's a lot of Brian in the morning that's very, like, just kind of sleepwalky, like whatever you can get by like nonverbal communications and grunts, like, you know, just that like survival kind of mode. And I remember this like it was yesterday. Ashley's cooking the tofu scramble, and Bonnie's very excited because obviously with all the allergies for the girls, like learning another recipe like that is a very big thing. Ashley's like, oh yeah, it's tofu scramble. And Brian just looks at it and goes, cool. To the cereal.
I mean, but it's one of those things that I was just not in that world. Like once you like doing this Eat to Live diet, like you really break your automatic habit of the entire, you know, standard American diet, right? Like all of a sudden, just entire chunks of it are off the menu. Like there's only like four soups I can even buy at the grocery store now, because everything else has meat in it. And it's like, you know, do you make any goddamn soups without meat? Really?
Do they make any goddamn soups without meat? We turn to Ashley Paramore, Ashley.
No, I don't know. Like, I feel like you're this way too, Ryan, and just how you shop with like the allergy stuff with the kids, where you just kind of scan to the bottom where it highlights all the allergens, right? So you know, but no, it can be hard with a lot of the Asian soups too, because they're all putting fish sauce in it or something else like that. In addition, they like egg.
By the way, you do realize, Brian?
Yeah.
That if you ever wanted us to relocate to Austin, Texas, that you need to for 2 solid years be doing nothing but just like in every platform you can talking about all the cool vegan restaurants and shops that exist around you. Like you need to do, there would need to be a sustained multi-year information campaign all the vegan possibilities.
Hold on. Let's take a tour of vegan Austin. I wonder what that looks like.
There is a vegan grocer that I remember stopping by last time I was out there. I think it's called Rabbit Food Grocery or something. I don't remember. I went there, but I bought some stuff and brought it back to your place.
Yeah.
If you're looking for meatless soups, you'll be able to probably find some stuff there.
Yeah. Let's see. 1, 2, 3. Topps Bravas Wild Taco. La Fantabulous. Masa Daba. Bangers. Sausage House. Wait, what? Oh, only one of the four vegetarian sausages is vegan. But hey, your dog will be happy. Yeah, all right, I'm going to have to make a habit. The problem is, man, so, yeah, see, here's where I'm at, man. I'm to a place where that vegan burger looks good.
Yeah, vegan burgers are actually not bad. I prefer the mushroom veggie burgers. I'm not a huge fan of, like, the patties.
Wait, you can get a local vegan burger patty? Wow.
What did we get at the Draft House last week?
It was some tofu thing.
It's a torta, right? You got a tofu torta?
Yeah.
Was it good?
For San Francisco vegan hipster food, it was... It was subpar. I ate it.
We probably could have hit up Gracias Madre before we saw the movie.
Oh my God, Gracias Madre is the best.
Hey, Media King 909 says, that ain't no vegan burger.
I don't think I've ever bugged you about a review of the San Francisco Draft House.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I don't think I've gotten the full story on that.
Oh, it's great. Really, there's like one. So number one, the theater is awesome because unlike all the other Alamo Draft Houses that I've been to, which are just great theaters that are kind of just sort of basic theaters. They're just kind of like a regular box, you know, but you get awesome stuff in it. This has like one of those old fashioned, like refurbed. Have you been to the Grand Lake Theater?
Yeah, I've been outside it. I haven't been inside. But I guess I have. I've seen the foyer in there.
So it's like just that that kind of like old style theater, but it's a draft house, so it like is awesome and it has all the cool stuff in it. The bar is rad, but it suffers from like custom cocktail bar syndrome where like everything takes a billion years to do at all times. Yeah. Right. And for whatever reason, they turn the music up really fucking loud. Like, so it's kind of annoying to have a conversation in there, which I think is kind of weird because like the point of that bar is to talk about movies before and after a movie. Right.
Yeah. That can't be a universal thing because by the way, so the Alamo Draft House we usually go to is the one on Slaughter Lane, right?
Yeah.
And recently I was going through my credit card statement and it just in all caps just said Alamo Slaughter. And I was like, oh, Slaughter Lane. But then I read it again with fresh eyes and I was like, that's probably not appropriate that it just says Alamo Slaughter.
Alamo. Oh, Jesus Christ. I didn't even realize. Yeah, no. And for more information on that, you can see in VR Brian and I a year ago at the Alamo.
Have you tried that yet?
I haven't tried it on the Vive yet. But I definitely need to do that.
Can you
believe that was a year ago?
No, man. It felt like it kind of freaked me out to realize like just how on it we were. Because was it before Christmas or right around this time? Or
before. Remember, because it ended when Star Wars came out.
Oh, that's right.
That was the last night.
I can't make that be a year ago. That's amazing.
It is a year ago.
Wow.
Yeah. No, because my Facebook, like, remember this year? Like a year ago, like I saw the graffiti picture that we took of us with the diamond,
right,
like in Graffiti Park.
Dude, I think you'll be really impressed with how different it is on the Vive because like it's like four times the resolution. And it's
I'm sure it's awesome. Yeah. I mean, like, you know, the way that they do the stitching and the resolution to pump it over, you know, cell phone stuff has to just be stepped on.
Yeah. Well, and I guess I didn't put that together at the time. Sorry. Like, I was like, oh, it's all blurry. And I was like, well, that must just be those cameras, whatever, right around.
Yeah. I mean, like the GoPros are, but then again, yeah, but like there's like really crisp images of GoPros. So stitching them together shouldn't necessarily take out too much of the fidelity out of it. Yeah. Periodically, I hear from Homeboy, though.
Which one?
The dude that we wound up running into at South By.
Oh, yeah. Right on.
And every time he's like, he's always very nice and he's very friendly and everything. And I always think he's going to be like, yeah, let's just, I don't know, where you guys want to come to Paris?
Like, dude, that's awesome. That was a really, really fun experience. I'm glad we got to do that.
Oh, my God. No, that was amazing. That was super, super, super good. Sunbun, L.A.'s never opening their Alamo. Didn't L.A. has an Alamo, right?
They've been talking about it forever.
Oh, geez. Well, hell, I mean, listen, if it takes as long as it took the San Francisco one, that was like slated to open before I moved and opened the 4.5 years after I'd worked at the Go Game. So take their time.
I got to tell you, man, I feel bad saying this. Like, I mean, I like the Alamo a lot, but there's a lot that's changed. You know, they've simplified the menu. It's a lot more boring. They don't do nearly the clever stuff. They're moving they're moving a lot more stuff faster, and they're also dumbing down a lot of the experience. Like
what?
Well, like reading all of the text on the screen for you. Like they never did that for like the first 8, 9, 10 years, and then at some point they're all like, here's how to order at the Draft House. Write your shit down on a piece of paper, put it up, and somebody will come get it. And it's like, I don't, it's not feeling
okay. No, you know that this is one of these Brian things that like is just a thing that you that like gets your goat, right? Like that's like not a thing that most people would like key in on. Like is that just like a flag for the larger thing?
No. Part of it is like, you know, it used to be that they would just, you know, they'd play some kick-ass cello music, and then they would just, you know, have 10 seconds of like, hey man, we're not fucking around here. Sit down, shut up, watch the movie. Don't show up late. Right. But yeah. But then now, you know, now they have somebody reading that same text to you in a way that colors your experience. And then,
but isn't the road to hell paved with them getting famous for the talking and texting thing?
Yeah. Yeah.
That now it's like, this is part of what people expect are these like little presentations of stuff, right? Yeah,
correct. But also, like, now they're crediting
Curtis LaRock. So this is what happens when things grow and change.
Well, and then plus also, like, the pre-shows, they're all curated and they have, shitty plugs that do nobody any good. Like, you could tell now that they find a video that they like on YouTube, they reach out to that person. That person says, yeah, man, give me a big old fat plug. And they show a dumb URL that literally not one person ever will go and look at, especially since the fact that the moment they pull out their cell phone to maybe type down this fucking ridiculous youtube.com/user/blah blah 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 blah, check out more of my doobadoos at it. It's like, you know, they're going to get shamed the moment they pull out their phone. It's dumb. It's dumb.
Yeah, I mean, the one thing that I do notice that has kind of changed is that there was a little bit when I first was going, which was not too long ago, so I have no window into the halcyon golden days of it, but like, there was a little bit more of a reckless abandonment for copyright.
Yeah, it was like they would do stuff like they would work around. They're like, hey, we're gonna have a. They're like, you're paying $20 for admission to an Andy Kaufman party where you can eat and drink and hang out with other people who like Andy Kaufman. Who's going to be on that screen? No idea. Because if you were coming for what was on the screen, then we'd be doing a showing of copyrighted material that doesn't belong to us. But you're not. You're attending the Andy Kaufman party, right? Yeah. Right? We're all clear, right?
Yeah, well, even, like, there was just, like, the one thing that I don't know, maybe it's just, I've just seen so many big event movies there that they're, like, because, like, the way that they want to do one of those pre-shows for, like, Star Wars is different than what they want to do for, like, midnight special or something, right? Or just some random movie that they like where they're doing like evocative trailers and like interviews with like the cast in old like things that like maybe part of it is because like I have found the stuff for like Doctor Strange and Star Wars a little lackluster, but maybe it's like for those for like Marvel movies, it's like, well, fuck, man, there's only so many old toy commercials we can like jam in there. And like, you know, I guess we'll do these fan films and these like viral videos that involve stuff.
At the Draft House, did they play the Seagulls Stop It Now before Rogue One?
Which is that?
Oh, have you not seen it?
I don't know. I don't know what it is, so.
All right, here, I'm going to take Seagulls Stop It Now. This is the latest from Bad Lip Reading. And it's pretty great for as elementary as it is. Here.
Yeah, man, it's too bad we can't stream this on Twitch.
I hate...
Wait, what? Wait, what?
Oh, no, keep playing it. I'm joking.
Oh, okay, all right. Here.
Brenda and a bad guy hit me in the shin and I peed all in my pants.
No, they did play this.
There's nothing a little music can't help. Rockin' and rollin', down to the beach I'm strolling. But the seagulls poke at my head, not fun. I said, seagulls, stop it now. Seagulls gonna come, poke me in the coconut, and they did, and they did, and me going like, nothing I could do but yell when these birds attack me. When I tried to run, I fell, and then these kids start laughing, and then got hit in the neck with a hacksaw. Put me down. I love to groove and boogie.
Great.
Show you some dance moves.
No, I don't want you to.
If I had your giant feet out there on the beach, could about run those birds.
You're a psycho wiener.
Let me grab my beater.
Sort of pitchy.
Didn't like it?
Listen, man, I'm not your friend.
Don't fall asleep.
Don't fall asleep.
Man, those fuckers are killing it, too. Remember when they were nobodies? And then they now they're at 6 million subs.
Well, you know, because now they're just doing these blockbuster ones with, like, you know, the Star Wars and the NFL and, like, all that. Like, the presidential debate things are just, like, they're just so good, man. They're awesome.
Wait, was their first one the Friday bad lip reading? No. Wait.
No. They were a thing before that.
Gang Fight would have been... wow. Yeah. I look like they're explaining it as interpreted by a bad lip reader.
Maybe it was.
Hey, this is certainly the first one I saw. Oh, no. Before that, they had the Everybody Poops.
Yeah.
And if you don't, you're an android. I'm making war, gotta beat those kids, no doubt. And I gotta poo at the house, here we go, let's leave. If I think that it's time I should go, I can say, oh, yeah. I gotta bring my chicken. Yeah, I know that sounds kind of messed up. Gonna get you with my pleasant Nazis, am I right? Hey, guys. Hey, Gunter. Hey, Hans. Gonna pay that blood, I'm gonna see it.
Oh, shit. I remember this. Game fight.
Yeah. When Patricia shows up, I just remember the ain't no chicken from China.
Skip to the Patrice part. All right.
Carp on the side. I got you, we can't free me up like JJ said. Now what kind of meat it was grinding? Yeah, we gotta wait on our food baloney. The clever thing about it was, like, you know, by changing the rhythm of the song, or I guess the rhythm, the emphasis of the song, you know, they were able to take it's Friday, and just completely subvert it, like, gang fight.
What is the backstory on bad lip reading? I don't even know, like, what they were doing before.
I don't know. What's the very first one they did? Let's see. Let's do.
Yeah, go. Let's do some. Because listen, if we do one more in a row, then we have to shut down.
All right, here we go. Let's go all the way back in time. They figured out the beauty of fair.
Nobody,
it was
asked you, Patrice.
It was.
Wow.
The very first. Wow.
Then what was next? What was the...
Asian Baby. It's their...
What was that? Oh, Rascal Flatts?
Yeah. Vermont is heaven. What do you mean? Wednesday, I was in Korea singing to this dark-haired girl. Yeah. It's so sad. Probably should...
So they were doing music, right? And then they got into... like these, like, more headier, crazy things with, like, TV and politics and music.
Oh, man,
and...
they made, hey, wow, this is back in the 2012 election.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
No, they were just grinding. Although, I guess that, at that point, because I remember the Michael Bublé one, and then I guess, like, as that election got super hot.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They went a little nuts on all this political stuff.
We have this from Jotman.
Yeah, hoy.
I have no idea what it is.
Well, since when has that ever stopped us?
Yeah, exactly.
Ah, I love this Christmassy time of year. Oh, excuse me. Call me Sam. What's the matter? Haven't you ever seen a talking snowman before? Nice around here, isn't it? I call it Christmas Town.
I think we get the point.
No, I'm sure the real joke is right around the corner.
Christmas seals.
Yeah, all right.
Is it murder, right? Everyone's getting murdered.
It's hilarious.
All right, man. I feel like we did good work here. This was a nice little fun little relaxing thing. It was great to do something with literally zero stakes.
Yeah, well, and we could do more of this because, like, here's the funny part is in addition to doing the show, we actually just get on and talk to each other. And then it's like he'll say something. I'll be like, what? That's crazy.
Do we want to end on something? What are some of those other classic bits that we used to do on BB Live Show? Like we did Rapid Fire, right? We did Brian's shirtless push-ups. Like, what are these? Some of the other bits that we used to do all the time?
Let's just go out with this.
Somewhere out there.
Bye, guys. Love you. Space.
Somewhere far away in space and time. Staring upward at the gleaming stars in the obsidian sky. We're marooned on a small island in an endless sea, confined to a tiny spit of sand, unable to escape. But tonight, on this small planet, on Earth, we're going to rock civilization.
Love you. Bye.
Peace.